Good evening. Specialist police have stormed a home in Melbourne's west to end a dramatic siege with an armed attacker. They tracked him to the Seddon property after he terrorised staff in a nearby chemist, threatening them with a crossbow, taser and knife.
For hours, he kept police guessing, suspected to be armed, inside a Seddon house after menacing staff in a nearby chemist.
Well, I just got shot by a crossbow. He had a knife and a taser.
Luckily, it just grazed the pharmacist's arm after he confronted the man earlier this afternoon because he thought he was stealing perfume.
He fired the taser at the guard and he threatened us with the knife.
The pharmacist defended himself.
Well, I quickly grabbed an umbrella and told him to get out.
Then chased him almost 2 kilometres, the accused attacker waving and using a weapon.
It looked like a bow and arrow because of the way he went like this. He fired. He did fire a shot.
The man hid in a house on Victoria Street. Nearby homes were evacuated and businesses closed. The police dog squad and an ambulance were on standby as heavily armed officers helped a housemate escape, taking no chances with weapons ready.
Police used a loudspeaker to communicate with the man. They asked for his phone number and then rang him. That began around 2 hours of negotiating.
Listen to me, mate. I want you to put down what's in your hands, walk towards me, and lay down on your stomach. Show me your hands. Lay down on your stomach.
The man finally came out, lured by police offering a lighter for his cigarette. He was grabbed and arrested. Earlier, it's believed he threatened staff at a nearby hotel in front of shocked patrons.
Chef was coming out screaming, he's got a knife, he's got a knife. The chef had an umbrella trying to get him out. And he just went out a side door and took off.
Police have just released some information about the man they arrested here. He is a 46-year-old from Seddon. They say he wasn't injured in today's siege and that tonight he is helping them with their investigation. In terms of one of the weapons he's believed to have been using, police, Mitch, have described it as a modified slingshot.
Paul Dowsley at Seddon, thank you.